my voice back because we are in open space here in the conference hall. A lot of people are watching our debate live as an audience. So we'll have about 30 minutes or something like that to do our debate. The issue is smoking ban in public spaces. Maybe you are aware of this situation according to the new laws passed the last years. You can see in the screen and a yellow post-it where a small description of the law where the smoking ban was introduced in Greece. Can you see this post or not?
Yeah, you can see it.
Yep.
Okay, so we are promoting measures, support measures to improve the situation and stop smoking in the public spaces. So we are here to listen to your opinions about this issue, if you agree or you disagree, or you have another opinion or another thought about smoking ban in public spaces.
Okay, so can you also tell us what are the posts on the left, the yellow boards on the left and on the right as well?
You can see on the left a statement to start our debate that says that we would like to raise our voice against calls and actions to ban smoking in pubs and clubs and restaurants. Can you easily see this post?
Yes, so this is a bit...
Yes.
Biased in a sense, so it says it's towards one side of the discussion, right?
Exactly, it supports smoking banning.
Okay.
On the other hand, there is on the right some links where you can click and easily see surveys and special surveys from Eurobarometer about tobacco, about smoking banning. There you can easily drag and drop your links if you have in your possession to support your speech.
Okay.
Over and above that, most of us are walking in a red and green carpet, a multicolored carpet, where a stick, you can easily see a stick or not.
Yes, if we push the button called push to vote.
You can see two sticks here. So if you agree with smoking banning, you are going to the green area of the carpet, or if you disagree, your vote, you can vote in the red area on the card.
So would you like us to start with, just giving us our opinion on the carpet and then start discussing that, or would you like to start discussing now and then based on the discussion, find out which are the intermediate questions that we need to answer and use the carpet in that way?
We can do both. We can make a nice break now and test the environment where we are where we are, and we can vote, and then we can vote at the end of our discussion and see if we have changed our mind or not.
Okay. So then probably we should invite everyone to just vote, put their bars on the carpet, and then place the bars on the carpet, and then start discussing about that.
Please feel free, take one and two minutes and post your vote.
So I think we get a picture of the general opinion. I would assume that the people that stand in the middle, have placed the bars in the middle, they could start expressing their opinion, because this is not the norm, this is not a straightforward opinion. Being not agreeing or not disagreeing with that. So is someone that placed their bars in the middle, does someone who plays the bars in the middle would like to explain us why?
In the middle position.
By listening to you. Please feel free to express your opinion. Now, why you support the red area of the carpet? Why you disagree with smoking banning in public spaces? And if you have any document or any link or any other idea or any other note, please feel free to post it.
So let me just start. Even though I totally agree with banning smoking on public places completely, I am just curious about this statement that you have on the left hand side board. So it says that the consequences of being of smoking in public places and of passive smoking in health, they are exaggerated. So I'm just wondering, is that the case? Do you have any evidence that it is exaggerated? Because if that's the case, then probably that shouldn't be a problem. I mean, everyone should be happy. If passive smoking is fine, then why ask people to quit smoking?
You are right. It's a provocative statement, just to ensure that we have a live debate. So I think here that in some cases, the statement says that a lot of people are exaggerating with a point of hysteria, where the risk of passive smoking has never been proved beyond the winning levels. So it's not proved that the deaths of people from cancer, for instance, are from passive smoking. This is the statement.
So are these formal statements, formal studies, experiments or whatever, that prove that thing, or is it just that some people just claim that? Or we don't know whether there are any just studies, we just know people who claim that.
Mostly the bar owners and the restaurant owners are claiming that. So it's just a claim from these people.
So it is a claim of people who have interest in not banning smoking, so I'm not sure it's objective as a claim, right?
It's not objective at all.
Yeah, I'm also wondering what is the stance of the smoking industry, I don't know how to call it. I mean, the factories and the industry in general that produces cigarettes and all the types of smoking products, and and all their derivatives, if I may say. So I assume that their stance is to discredit, let's say, the all the claims from scientists and so on that passive smoking is unhealthy, or do they stand and just say, okay, this is fine, but you know there are other things that you need to consider, which I currently can think about.
I'm not sure about that. I don't have all the studies in my possession. Maybe we can move to the links we have on the other hand, on the other side of the arena, of the, and see what's going on. We can easily go there and see the studies and the statistics. So let's go there and see if we find any clue, any statistics that will help our discussion. Did you click the statistics or not? Do you have them in your computer?
Yeah, we can see them. So, by doing a quick search on the web, I just realize that there are quite a few articles that claim that the tobacco industry had started a campaign against all these scientists and people saying that passive smoking is unhealthy. You know, maybe this is just a conspiracy theory, but it seems that the interests are quite significant there. But I mean, disregarding the fact that passive smoking can be unhealthy, there are other factors I think that should provoke people for smoking in public, in the sense that you know, it's a kind of a violation of the non-smoker's privacy, in a sense. I mean, I couldn't just go around and start, I don't know, spitting people that are in public, that are standing next to me, just because I like that. I mean, there should be some consequences in that, and I think that this is a very valid equivalent of smoking in public without really caring about the people around you. So I think that there are also ethical and community, I don't know, social, let's say, reasons for that should prevent people from smoking in public.
What I want also to say is, first of all, I would like to say that I agree with the smoking ban in public places, but I also think that we should somehow consider the smokers as well, meaning that the smokers are there. Most of the people are smoking, maybe equal to those that they don't. So whatever we are thinking of enforcing, whatever law we are thinking of applying, we should also consider the smokers. I am a non-smoker. I really hate going to a public place and as Kate Serpes said, people around me are smoking without even caring about the non-smokers. But on the other hand, if we enforce a law that says that we forbid everyone from smoking, we ban smoking in public places, then we go to the other side. The smokers will be the one that will feel disappointed, and then we'll just go to the other side. What I'm trying to say is that we can find a solution in the middle somehow.
I said too. Hi. I had been a smoker for like 13 or 14 years. I quit 7 months ago. I voted for the smoking ban in all public places because I strongly realized after I quit smoking how obnoxious it is to other people when people around them smoke in a closed, confined space. Moreover, when I still was a smoker and visited the countries in Europe before the smoking banning was invoked here, I had never had a problem to go outside and smoke. People are used to it by now, and smokers never feel, or most of them at least, never feel neglected or disappointed by smoking banning, at least in most countries in Europe. It's very rude right now, I think, to smoke when other people around you who don't. It's like, I don't know, like Costa said, like speaking very loud in the next person's ear, or doing, I don't know, obnoxious gestures or something else. It's very, very annoying. Right now, I am at a point where I find it very disturbing that people totally neglect the law with the sole purpose of turning more profit because they are losing customers since the smoking ban has been invoked. But if everybody was obliged to uphold the law, then there would never be a problem. So I am totally for the smoking banning, and I think the middle place would be very difficult to apply, especially in Greece. The middle class, I think, is perhaps unachievable in Greece.
Maybe because in Greece, all the owners, most of the owners of bars, restaurants, etc., as you said, they're thinking that they're going to lose some money if they will actually enforce the sign that they have, this non-smoking sign. We all go to such kind of places. There's a large sign saying non-smoking, but you can definitely see people above this sign smoking without noticing, or even if they notice, they don't care. But as I said, on the other hand, these people should also have some places to go. So what can be done, I think, is that the owners of these public places, for example, if I'm an owner of a restaurant, I should decide what I want to do with my the restaurant. Should it be a non-smoking restaurant or a smoking restaurant? I know that, especially in Greece, most of the people will decide to go for a smoking restaurant because a lot of people smoke. But I think that in this way we should be somewhere in the middle and let the owners of the public places to decide.
But according to the Greek reality, I think this way the non-smoking restaurants or bar or etc. will be empty. So the restaurant and bar owners will be gradually enforced to make it a smoking restaurant.
I understand, but I'm not sure if they're going to be empty, because, for example, let's see, here we are, I don't know, 10 people probably. I don't know if someone is smoking. I mean, I will go definitely to a non-smoking place, even
yes,
a bar or a restaurant.
A friend of yours who are going out with would like to go to a smoking place. So there is a high percentage of people smoking. You know, we all have fellows that are smoking.
I'm afraid I will agree with Fotis.
So the thing is that it's more than one of the things that Elias was mentioning. In the case of Greece, at least, it will end up in something like the dictatorship of the majority or something like that. But there are other cases that we have witnessed, I think, at least abroad in European countries and the States and so on, in which you can see that the absolute banning of smoking in public places has not really worked against the restaurant owners and the bar owners and so on. I believe that you know banning smoking totally on in public places would eventually lead into you know even smoking even people who are smoking to go to these bars and go to these restaurants without really saying no, I'm not going to do that. But the, you know if something like what Elias is proposing, there will be people that will be left outside just because they would not be able to go. Do you know what I mean? I'm not sure I expressed correctly, but do you get my point?
Yes, I think I understood, Kostas, but as we said, we are basically discussing the Greek reality here, and I don't know if the absolute smoking banning in all public spaces would be feasible. For example, let's think about Bouzoukia and places like that. Maybe what we need here in Greece to start step by step, to start with something that I call a middle solution, and then we should probably then we can end up to a absolute smoking banning. We have seen that, many times the government has tried to enforce the law. I don't know, the moderator can also say about that. I mean, I think that there is a law now that has been applied, that it is operative law, smoking banning in all public places. I haven't been to a single restaurant or bar where the smoking banning is forbidden.
The enforcement is something that I completely agree. So it's not a matter of culture, of the way of thinking of the Greeks, but also of the law enforcement and the way that the Greek people are thinking. So we cannot leave empty room to a space to the restaurant owners or the pub owners or these people that we support smoking in public spaces. So I think the enforcement is the key. What is your opinion about that? What about the enforcement?
I do believe that the enforcement is practically impossible to work. The only way to enforce such kind of measure is to persuade people that it's in their common, let's say, benefit to oblige to such a law. And sometimes it's just a matter of culture, to be honest, even though I understand what you're saying, that, you know, in other southern countries that present the same, present similarities as in terms of culture, like Greece, it has worked. I tend to believe that still there will be a Greek case, as you said, as you called it. There will still be, you know, the Greeks comprising an exception to the rule, because it's a matter of culture, of a kind of different culture that Greeks probably have. I cannot really imagine, you know, policemen chasing around people just because they smoked and proposing fines and whatever that might mean. That would be impossible, not feasible to my mind.
And also, enforcing the law hasn't worked twice till now. Why it should work now?
Yes, this is probably something that we must consider. I mean, the enforcement, as the moderator put it in the, here in this discussion, is very important. As Foti said, twice the law has been applied and hasn't been enforced, meaning that, as I said before, I have never seen a restaurant with which actually people don't smoke in it. So Maybe it is a matter of our culture. I agree on that too, and I also say that this is a Greek case. So how we can enforce the law? There is a discussion going on in several places in the web about the penalties, about all this, the money that should the owner of the park place should pay. But even that, even if the law is very strict, still I think that the people who are responsible for the law, I mean the people who are going to, who have the difficulty to enforce the law, cannot do it. As Costa said, we cannot imagine policemen running around chasing people that are smoking. I remember that there was also a line, a telephone line that someone can call in order to, call for the police for the places where the smoking is forbidden. This didn't happen as well. Maybe, are we sure that the people that want the law to be enforced really want to do that? I mean, are we sure about that?
We are going into a matter of corruption in the public sector and so on. It's very complicated. I mean, of course, most of the regional people who control pubs and bars and so on, like the mayors and so on, they don't want to lose their voters because,
exactly.
Especially
exactly.
For example, in my town, I live in a small town in the coast. We are like 10,000 people here, so there are many bars and pubs and restaurants, and this is the voting pool for all mayors. So they don't to have bad relations with the owners of all these shops just because they want to enforce the smoking ban. But on the other hand, it's a law of the state. I mean, come on. At some point, some laws have to be upheld. And of course, another matter why this law is difficult to uphold is the matter that people are inert to change. We are used to smoking not being banned and being free, and now we resent any kind of change just because it is in quote marks it's enforced. We have also issues with authority and so on, but we have to accept the fact that it is rude to smoke in closed spaces with other people who don't smoke. It's ruder than going outside, just being forced to go outside to smoke. I mean, it is very basic social behavior.
Yes, I totally agree with all what you said. And first of all, that's what I tried to imply before, saying that if the public authorities really want the law to be enforced, because I think that they don't. I also agree with the examples that you gave. So first of all, we should start from there. I mean, the government, when applies the law, then first of all must make the public authorities to enforce the law. Secondly, yes, it is rude, of course, for me, being non-smoker, to have someone beside me to smoke, and it is rude for people that goes outside to smoke. So that's why I said in the beginning that maybe a solution could be to separate the places, at least at the beginning, to smoking and non-smoking. So everybody would have his place to go. I know that some people from people that I go out with are smokers, so first time we will go to a smoking place, then we will go to a non-smoking place, something that we can handle between us. But as I see things, if the public authorities won't enforce the law, then how can people accept it? How can people comply with it? I'm not the one that I should go to a bar and I should fight or, say bad words to the people that smoke besides me. If I consider the law as it is right now, which is, as I said, is a law which has been applied. I can go to a restaurant and I can call the police. So why should I fight with the people that are smoking in a restaurant and not the public authorities do that for me?
I tend to disagree in the sense that this is not, there's no reason in what you're saying. I mean, you cannot, whenever the state, you know, brings a new law into action, this doesn't mean
this doesn't mean
that they do have to also figure out ways to enforce the law. I mean, a government that brought a law into action is the one that has been selected, I guess, by the majority of the people. I assume that we're talking about democratic a democratic state, which means that the people brought this this party or this group of people to power because they believe that they can represent them wisely, let's say. So the decision that they make, they shouldn't be questioned at any time. I mean, I understand that they should be questioned at some point, but you know, questioning to the extent that I'm not following this law, this is problematic. This is a fundamental problem in the democratic operation, in the operation of a democratic state. So I don't believe that you know, a law should come with enforcement rules or anything like that. Maybe it's utopic, of course. Yes.
But on the other hand, when the public authorities apply a law, then we start, and especially for the smoking banning case, the law started, and of course the moderator can correct me if I'm wrong here, the law started saying smoking, we will enforce smoking banning in all public places. Then after people, basically the owners of the restaurants and bars, etc., started to argue on that, saying what we're going to do with places, we're going to close, we don't know, etc. Then they started to add some exceptions in the law, saying, for example, that bouzoukia, or places with over than, I don't know the exact number of people, would allow smoking. And that is what is happening all the time. That is why I said before that it is first that the government, and secondly the public authorities, it's their responsibility to enforce the law.
Can I say something on that? We're asking from the government, from the local or from the public authorities to enforce the law. But we always forget that it's our obligation to follow the laws. This is the crucial point.
Mm-hmm.
The crucial point is that we don't respect the laws. So it's a matter of respect. So, do you hear me well or not? I'm far away from the microphone.
We can hear some chairs as well.
Okay, I'll go back of the screen and I will reach the microphone. Do you hear me now? Do you hear me now?
Yeah,
right now. Yes, I'm behind the screen. So, It's a matter of the people do not respect the laws in general. But this is not our conversation now. Here we are talking about smoking ban. I fully understand that this combination of culture and enforcement. Any other ideas? Do you have any other ideas or to add in this debate regarding smoking banning?
Yes, I would like to say that before the government forced smokers not to smoke in public places, the government should ask what people really want, all of them. Because even if I agree that smoking in a public place should be banned, because I'm a non-smoker too, as well. I think that first of all, the government should respect the general opinion on this issue.
No, sorry, I don't agree with that. At some points in history, the public has proved that the public opinion is wrong. I mean, even if you ask today the majority of people if they want to wear a safety belt while driving, most of them would say no. That doesn't mean that the state should follow and...
This is the matter of democracy. This is the idea of democracy. Doing what the majority wants.
Yeah, but still.
Okay. I think that first of all, they should make some research on this issue. If passive smoking do harm, in what extent, and if passive smoking was so dangerous, I think that they should prove this with they should prove this and convince people with that.
So what you're saying, Sophia, the thing is that there are two sides. One side provides evidence that smoking is harmful for people and passive smoking is harmful as well. So the other side says that the passive smoking is not as harmful as Sophia is trying to mute the microphone.
Sorry guys, it has backed.
Okay, so there are two sides. Which side do you believe? The one side has a direct financial interest into claiming that the other side is wrong. The other side doesn't seem to have any economic benefit from saying, you know, that the other side is wrong. So which one would you pick in this case?
I think the best way to smoking banning is to give financial motive to the corona. I think that the best way to enforce the smoking banning in every store imaginable is to give financial motive to store owners, probably to lower the taxes or the VAT. If a store has 10% or 15% less taxes to pay, that is a very nice motive to enforce the smoking banning. Of course, that implies a very effective control mechanism, so that nobody who doesn't apply the law gets the benefits of lower taxes. And moreover, it's a psychological measure because it doesn't rely on fines and people, you know, snitching who is smoking, who is not. And I think too that people would prefer, because they would prefer to go to a pub whose prices are 10% lower than the next one, and they just should go outside and smoke. Maybe this could work, I don't know.
I agree. I think this is a very good idea. Give such motives to restaurant owners and bar owners that have the disadvantage of banning smoking in their store.
But also check if they lower their price too, you know.
We will record the good ideas. Do you hear me now? Okay. So we have to follow if the law is enforced or not. We have to follow if we respect the public consultations, because we have done public consultations, and I replied to a previous question from Sophia.
regarding the law. So we have a public opinion about that. We have the European opinion, a European Commission opinion about tobacco consumption, smoking in Europe, health diseases caused by smoking, etc., etc. So we have a backup information for that, and we can find that in the next debate we can organize in other social networks. You can easily see the pigeon in front of the carpet, where other social networks can inform us about what's going on in other debates for the same topic that happens in Twitter and in Facebook and in Blogger. I want to thank you very much, everybody, that you have posted your ideas. It be constructive if we can post your ideas and put some posters. Could you do that? Could you know how to do that?
Sorry, Dimitris, can you please repeat what you asked?
Where should we post our ideas?
Could you hear me?
Yes.
Okay. To post your ideas with stickers in this environment, I need constructive and one paragraph ideas about how we enforce and how we will ensure that we interfere somehow in the culture of Greeks to follow and respect the law. This is, I think, the conclusion of our debate until now. Could you do that? Could you post your idea with stickers? Is it possible?
How do we do that?
You don't know, eh? Even the insert object.
Can you add one or two posts, and then we can post the opinions in the post that you will create. I can see one.
Yes, I found it. Please. Insert the object and the note. I am trying to edit now.
Could you see the sticker I posted or not?
Yeah, we can see it.
In the middle. Can you post your ideas? Can you write down? I think Kostas has a solution, eh?
Yeah, I'm currently writing.
Bravo, Kostas.
Okay, maybe we should just instead of doing that, maybe you could also just go with some final question or statement, vote in the carpet, and finish this off. My suggestion was to pose the one or two questions. I think the one that we definitely disagreed, and I think with Elias, was the thing that I wrote actually wrote in the sticky note, and the argument was whether the restaurant bars and so on, this type of economy will be harmed if smoking banning is enforced. And I think at some point Elias said, okay, we should probably go in with a midway house solution rather than with with such an extreme measure. And I tend to disagree, because such an extreme measure won't hurt this type of industry of business. Instead, they will continue working as they did. That's one of the arguments that we could discuss, but there are also others, of course.
And maybe now that you're mentioning Kostas, maybe Dimitri, this could be a good idea of a poll. I mean, to ask people if they think that these local economies will be hurt from the smoking banning. Because if, for example, we see that people believe that it won't, meaning that they will still continue going to these places, then this argument of not banning smoking won't stand. So it would be better for the law to be enforced.
So we are talking about measures of this policy. I clearly will see after your votes, your final votes, about the crucial question. Do you agree with smoking ban in the public spaces? If you agree with that, and we see that in a few minutes, as Kostas proposed, then we can move to selected measures, selected articles of the law about enforcement, about culture, how we can enforce it better or not, how we can inform the local economies about that, how we can follow the efficient application of the law. This is the crucial question. This is the crucial question after the acceptance of the society that we have to ban smoking in public spaces. So if
but
you agree with that...
But I think all of the people will agree on that. I mean, the percentage will be too high. But then, even for the people that they do smoke, but then they will ask exactly what you said afterwards. I mean, they will vote, they will favor a smoking ban in public places, but they will start asking how this could be applied. I mean, the crucial point here is how the law will be applied, and then the questions start raising. For example, the bars, the local economies that we said, etc.
The law is strict, and it says exactly the enforcement measures. It's clear. So we move to the next step, which is, if we are ready, and from one side we say, yes, we agree as a society that smoking should be banned, should be banned in public spaces, and then as smokers, let's say the 40% of us are smokers, according to statistics, are familiar or are encouraging smoking ban in public spaces. Is full contradictory. You can understand that we agree for smoking ban in public spaces. On the other hand, if we have free space to smoke, we smoke, which is something very strange. Any other ideas?
No, I think.
We can vote now. We can vote now and see if we have changed our opinion. from the previous question, from the previous vote, sorry.
So the question now is if we agree on smoking banning in all public places?
Yes, we have the same question again. And then we'll move to the final question.
So it seems that only Bullis has placed his bar on the other extreme of the carpet. So maybe he wants to explain us why.
I have the same question, but based on the avatar I see, it's an extreme avatar. Eh? So let's listen him.
Okay, he changed his opinion, I think.
Due to you, eh? Maybe you forced him.
Okay, so what's the next step now?
The next step is the final question that came up from our discussion. Let me think about that. It's a live discussion, so I'm not prepared about this question. The question is, are you happy with the enforcement measures in public spaces for smoking banning or not? Are you happy or not?
Yeah.
You mean if we agree with the enforcement measures if we are happy with what has been used so far as enforcement measures?
The second one.
Okay.
So if we want to say no, we obviously go to I disagree.
Exactly.
Everybody got it? So the reason I'm standing here in the middle is that because that I have no problem with the measures, because I don't think it's a matter of enforcement, is a matter of this type of measures. It's a type of culture, so I'm fine with the measures. I'm not fine with other things.
So you think that the enforcement is not the proper one?
No, I think that it's okay. I think that it's difficult to get in better, and the measures for the enforcement, they make no sense. It has to be a matter of culture, that's what I mean.
Even I agree with you, I have to ask the other people if it's a matter of culture or not. If it's a matter of culture, you can vote the green area, in the green area, if it's not in the red area. Please vote for that as Kostas proposed, and I agree with him. So it's clear that it's a combination of enforcement measures and culture. So that's it. So we have to rethink about that and somehow persuade our citizens, our colleagues, our friends. We have to rethink about that. It's not clear to me.
I think this is a topic that we should take with us and think about it offline, I guess.
Offline and come back again to the social networks and post new questions about this policy.
I would also like to mention that all the people that participated will receive a questionnaire, and I kindly ask from all of you to say a few words about the environment, to answer the questions about the experience you had in this 3D Wonderland debate.
I thank you very much for your participation, and I think we have somehow to close our debate and come back again in other social networks, in Twitter, in Facebook, in Blogger, for the same policy, and as Elias proposed to read our questionnaire and answer it, please.
Kostas Fotis, people from NTUA, you do have their emails, I suppose, and we can send the questionnaires, right?
Yes, of course.
Okay, great.
Okay. Thank you again.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Bye.
Bye.
Bye, everyone.